Okay, good morning to all of you. I welcome to all in our lecture series on Mathematical Physics, that is your core paper 5 belongs to third semester BSc Physics Honor syllabus. In our last class we have been discussed in detail how to solve this partial differential equation by using separation variable method. In short, I have been written SVM. Here the boundary conditions are given, x equal to 0, u equal to 0, and d del u by del x equal to 1 plus e to the power minus 3y. In detail, we have been discussed this problem in our last class, okay? In today's class, we are going to discuss about Laplace equation, which is your this one in general. Or in your Cartesian coordinate system, the Laplace equation is this one. Del square u by del x square, del square u by plus del square u by del y square plus del square u by del z square equal to 0. In this class, we are going to discuss how to solve this equation by using SVM or your separation variable method. Okay. Before that, I am going to show you that what are the things or what are the questions already we have been discussed in our previous classes. You can see that this one was our first question what we solved. Here you can see that we consider the constant as k, okay, and then this one was our second question. Here also we have been considered the constant equal to k, and here you can see that this is our third question, and for this question we have been considered constant is equal to minus alpha square. Okay, so here one thing I am going to suggest to you, that this constant can be taken anything as you wish. So here I taken minus alpha square, you can consider minus k square, plus k square, anything, no problem. Accordingly you are going to get the solutions. So to get a particular format of the solution, here we have been considered as minus alpha square is the constant, okay, but here there is no restriction that you can take anything. You can consider the constant will be plus k or k square or plus alpha square or alpha, anything you can take, there is no issue. Okay, now we have to move to our today's class, that is your solving the Laplace equation. Okay, so here somewhat about the introduction about Laplace equation I have been written. You have to also write in a note. The Laplace equation in general written as del square u equal to 0. Okay. In physics, this equation has wide applications in solving different real-time problems such as study of electrostatics, heat flow equations, velocity potential in hydrodynamics problems, and particle in three-dimensional box, that is your quantum dot, whatever you are going to be studying, you know, fifth and sixth semester, okay, and etc. Many problems can be solved, or many real-time problems or partial differential equation can be solved or can be represented by with the help of Laplace equation and solved by separation variable method. Here we have been considered Cartesian coordinate system and its corresponding Laplace equation. In 3D Cartesian coordinate system, the Laplace equation is given by del square u equal to del square u by del x square plus del square u by del y square plus del square u by del z square equal to 0. Let this is your equation number 1, and here del स्क्वायर इक्वल टू डेल स्क्वायर बाय डेल एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस डेल स्क्वायर बाय डेल वाई स्क्वायर प्लस डेल स्क्वायर बाय डेल जेड स्क्वायर. एज वी नो दैट डेल इज ए ऑपरेटर एंड विच इज नथिंग बट आई कैप डेल बाय डेल एक्स जे कैप डेल बाय डेल वाई प्लस के कैप डेल बाय डेल जेड. So if I am going to consider del dot del, then this dot this one. So I cap del by del x, again I cap del by del x, we can get del square by del x square, del square by del y square, whenever j component is going to be multiplied with the j component, del square by del y square and del square by del z square. That we know in our first semester itself. From equation number one, one can be perceived that, or it can be clearly visible that this function u have the three independent variables, that is your x, y, z. So here u is the function which is dependent upon x, y, z. So u is the function of x, y, z. It can be written as u equal to u function of x, small y and small z. Here, whenever I am writing small z, I am writing this one. Z, one line at the middle. And capital Z, I simply represented as z. Okay. So, you have to keep these things in your mind. Now, to use the separation of variable method, that is your SVM, let us consider the general solution of equation number 1 will be equal to u equal to x capital X, which is the function of only X, capital Y, which is the function of only Y, capital Z, which is the function of only Z. So u is the general solution will be equal to X into Y into Z, capital X into capital Y into capital Z. Let this is your equation number 3. Here we are considering step by step, okay. Then what we have to do? Now from equation number 3, here by using equation number 3, we can found del square u by del x square, del square u by del y square, del square u by del z square, and then we have to put here, okay. So to find out del square u by del x square, here at the right hand side x, y, z are there. So whenever it is going to be differentiated with respect to x, y and z will be constant, okay, that we know in our previous classes. So now from equation number 3, del square u by del x square, we can get y into z, which are considered as act as constants, because y is the function of only y, z is the function of only z. So these two will be the constant when u will be differentiated with respect to x. So del square u by del x square will be y, capital z into del square capital x by del x square. Let this is your equation number 4. And similarly, del square u by del y square will be capital x, capital z, del square y by del y square. Equation number 5, del square u by del z square will be x, capital y, del z square by del small z square. See, here z and I put a line in between the z. So this is considered a small z, this is your capital z. Del square capital z by del z square. Let this is your equation number 6. Now we have to put equation number 4, 5 and 6 in our equation number 1. The equation number 1 is this one. Here we have to put the values, whatever we got in equation number 4, 5, 6. Okay. So by substituting 4, 5, 6 in equation number 1, we get yz. z into del square x by del y square plus xz into del square y by del y square plus xy into del square z by del z square equal to 0. Now we have to divide xyz. You just recall, after getting this one, we have to divide xyz. Okay, that means we have to divide, suppose you use the function of xy, then we have to divide xy. Here, you use the function of xyz, so we have to divide xyz. You just recall the procedure. Whatever we have been discussed in our first class of this topic, separation variable method. Okay, now we have to divide xyz with above equation. What we can get? Yz by xyz del square x by del x square, xz by xyz del square y by del y square, xy by xyz del square z by del z square equal to 0. So here yz got cancelled. 1 by x into del square x by del y del x square plus 1 by y into del square y by del y square plus 1 by z into del z square by del z square. del square z by del z square equal to 0, right? So that implies here 1 by x into del square x by del x square is equal to, take this two term right hand side, it will be minus 1 by y into del square y by del y square minus 1 by z into del square z by del z square. Let this is your equation number 7. Also you consider this one is your equation number 7. It will be required in our discussion. Okay, so now here we are going to be solve this equation number 7 by considering the constant. Okay, you just recall that what are the procedure we have been followed for SVM. I'm going to show you that. May you remember that first we have to consider the general solution, then we have to divide x, y, then we have to evaluate individual solutions. By considering the constant. Okay, you just recall. Now here in your equation number 7, you can see that LHS equal to RHS. So here we can consider that this LHS equal to RHS will be equal to a constant. So now consider LHS and RHS of equation number 7 is equal to constant K1 square. So here we have been considered case 1, considering positive constant. Here we consider this one is your positive constant. And as I told that, you can consider that this positive constant as K1 or K1 square. No problem. No issue. Okay. So here this positive constant can be considered as only K1 or K1 square. Here we have been considered as K1 square. Positive constant K1 square. Then we have to consider the negative constant. What will be the solution? That we are going to discuss. You just wait. So here LHS and RHS of equation number 7 is equal to a constant K square, say. Okay, then 1 by x del square x by del x square will be equal to K1 square. Let this is your equation number 8. And RHS is nothing but 1 by minus 1 by y into del square y by del y square minus 1 by z del square z by del z square equal to K1 square. Let this is your equation number. Okay. Then, now, consider the equation number 8. The 8 is nothing but 1 by x. Here you can see the equation number 8 is this one. Now, first we have to solve this equation number 8. Here you can see this will be 1 by x del square x by del x square equal to K1 square. That implies del square x by del x square will be equal to minus k1 square x equal to 0. Let this is your equation number 10. Now consider the auxiliary equation of this differential, second order differential equation. The auxiliary equation will be m square, because we know that del by del x is nothing but m. So here del square by del x square will be equal to m square, right? So m square minus k square will be equal to 0. This is your auxiliary equation of this equation number 10. So here we can get the two roots. We got two roots. What are the two roots? So m square will be equal to minus, will be equal to k1 square, or m will be equal to plus or minus k. So we got the two roots as plus k and minus k. So hence the solution of solution of equation number 10. Therefore the solution of equation number 10 will be how much? Capital X will be equal to a constant e to the power k1x plus b e to the power minus k1x. That we know that if we have the two roots, that is your k1 and k2, then the solutions will be a e to the power k1x and b e to the power, sorry, k1 and minus k1, k1x b e to the minus k1x. So these two are to be considered as the solutions of this differential equation, or the linear combination of these two solutions also be the solution of this differential equation. So in general we can write that a e to the k1x plus b e to the minus k1x is the solution, general solution of the differential equation, second order differential equation 10. Let this is your equation number 11. Here I am going to be say to one thing, that suppose you have been considered that the constant is your k, okay, constant is your k. Suppose you are considered that 1 by x into del square x by del x square equal to k, then what is the solution you are going to get? Here you can get m square minus k1 will be equal to 0, m equal to plus or minus root k1 root over, okay, root over of plus or minus root over of k1. So for you, suppose if you considered k1 is your constant, then the solution will be a e to the power root over of k1 into x plus b e to the power minus root over of k1 x. Okay. If we considered k1 is your constant, is our constant, instead of k1 square, the solution will be this much. So there is no issue that you can consider instead of k1 square k1. No issue, no problem. You can consider instead of k1 square k1. But here we considered k1 square because in this format, you can found the solution of the quantum dot or particle in three-dimensional box, particle in a three-dimensional box, whatever you are going to study in your fifth semester quantum mechanics and sixth semester nanomaterials and applications. At that time, you can get that this type of this format, in this format, they have been solved. Each and every book has been considered k1 square. Most of the book have been considered solved this problem by considering the Laplace equation, where most of the book has been considered as k1 square or constant square. They have been considered k1 square. Okay, so only for that we are considered here k1 square instead of k1. But again and again I am going to say to you that you can consider k1 instead of k1 square. There is no issue. Okay, if we are going to consider k1, your solution will be this much. Okay, now then you have to consider RHS. Then RHS will be minus 1 by y, this one. RHS of equation number 7. माइनस वन बाई वाई इंटू डेल स्क्वायर वाई बाई डेल वाई स्क्वायर माइनस वन बाई जेड इंटू डेल स्क्वायर जेड बाई डेल जेड स्क्वायर इक्वल टू के वन स्क्वायर. दैट इम्प्लाइज वन बाई वाई इंटू डेल स्क्वायर वाई बाई डेल वाई स्क्वायर इक्वल टू हियर माइनस माइनस इज दैर. सो इफ आई विल टेक माइनस दिस साइड इट विल माइनस के वन स्क्वायर एंड दिस विल प्लस अगेन इट विल बी मूव टू दिस साइड इट विल माइनस अगेन. सो माइनस के वन स्क्वायर माइनस वन बाई जेड डेल जेड बाई डेल स्क्वायर जेड बाई डेल डेल जेड स्क्वायर हियर मिस्टेक लिया रिटर्न डेल डेल जेड स्क्वायर ओके डेल जेड स्क्वायर डेल स्क्वायर जेड बाय डेल जेड स्क्वायर ओके डेल स्क्वायर जेड बाय डेल जेड स्क्वायर दिस इज स्मॉल जेड डेल जेड स्क्वायर. नाउ दिस वन वन बाय वाई एंड हियर दिस इक्वल टू दिस वन इक्वल टू अनदर कॉन्स्टेंट के टू स्क्वायर से ओके. हियर फ्रॉम इक्वेशन नंबर सेवन RHSF equation number 7, we found this one equal to this one. Minus k1 square minus 1 by z, del square z by del z square, equal to another constant, k2 square, say. Okay. So now, this one, 1 by y del square y by del y square will be equal to k2 square. So, del square y by del y square minus k2 square equal to k2 square. Y equal to 0, equation number 12, by considering the auxiliary equation, we can found the two roots, m equal to plus or minus k2, and the general solution will be y equal to c, k2y plus d e to the minus k2y of the equation number 12. The general solution of this equation number 12 will be this one. So, if you are going to consider instead of k2 square, k2, suppose you consider k2 is the positive constant k2, then your solution will be c e to the power root over of k2y plus d e to the minus root over of k2y. Okay. So, you can consider instead of k2 square k2, there is no issue. Now, we have to consider this one, that means this the RHS of this week, this is the LHS from which we found y, and the RHS of this equation is equal to this one, this equal to k2 square. Okay, so minus k1 square minus del square z by del z square equal to k2 square. That implies del square z by del z square will be equal to minus k2 square minus k1 square, and del z square del square z by del z square will be equal to minus k2 square plus k1 square. Let this k1 k2 square plus k1 square equal to k3 square, so minus k3 square. So this will be equal to plus k3 square. Consider minus k2 square plus k1 square equal to plus k3 square. So that implies del square z by del z square minus k3 square z equal to 0. Considering auxiliary equation of this one, we can found m square minus k3 square equal to 0, m equal to plus or minus k3. General solution of this equation number 14 will be equal to z equal to e into e to the power k3z plus f into e to the minus k3 z. Similarly, instead of plus k3 square, if you are going to consider k3 here the constant, then you are going to get the solution as e to the power root over of k3 z plus f into e to the minus root over of k3 z. Okay, this much changes you are going to get. So now here we got individual solutions, that z equal to this one, y equal to this one, and x equal to this one. Now we have to put this x, y, and z in our general solution, that is your in equation number 3. Here the equation number 3 is told that u equal to x into y into z. So whatever we got individual solution, that we are going to be substitute if I am going to substitute, then x capital X is nothing but this one. We found here a e to the k1x, b e to the minus k1x. Similarly, capital Y will be c e to the k2y, d e to the minus k2y, minus k2y, and z equal to this one, e to the k3z plus f into e to the minus k3z. This is the general solution of the Laplace equation in the Cartesian coordinate system. Okay. By considering positive constant. So here, as I told that if you are going to be considered instead of k1 square k1, k2 square k2, k3 square k3, if you are going to be considered like this, then your general solution will be root over of k1 minus root over of k1, here root over of k2 minus root over of k2, root over of k3 minus root over of k3. This much changes you can get. Okay. Next, we have to consider the negative constant. That means the equation number 8, whatever we got here, you can see the equation number 8 is your this one. Here we consider minus k1 square is your plus k1 square is your positive constant. So if we are going to consider minus k1 square, that means a negative constant, then what type of solution? If we are going to consider minus k1 square, then what type of solution we are going to be get? Let see. So by considering negative constant, we can found del square x by del x square equal to minus k1 square x. That implies del square x by del x square plus k1 square x equal to 0. Let this is your equation number 17, because previous one was our 16. Okay. So considering now auxiliary equation of this equation number 17, we can found m square plus k1 square equal to 0, where m will be equal to plus or minus ik. You can see this, m square equal to minus k1 square. So m will be equal to plus or minus your root over of minus 1 means ik1. Okay. So here also I am going to suggest that if you are going to consider instead of k1 square, if you consider minus k1, okay, then what will be happen? Here the auxiliary equation will be m square plus k1 will be equal to 0. And you are going to get the two roots as m equal to, here m square will be minus k1, m square will be minus k1. And m will be equal to plus or minus I root over of k1. Okay. So instead of plus or minus I k1, you will be get plus or minus I root over of k1 if you are going to consider k1 instead of k1 square. So you can consider. There is no issue. Okay. Here I considered square, k1 square, to the aim of our the 5th semester and 6th semester, whatever we have the content or topics, on the base of that, here I have been considered k1 square, but you can consider k1, no, there is no issue. So here we got m equal to plus or minus I k1. The general solution or the solution of equation number 17 will be equal to x equal to a e to the power ik1x plus b e to the minus ik1x. Let this is your equation number 18. Similarly, the solution of equation number 12. Where is the equation number 12? Yes, this one. Here. Equation number 12. This one or this one itself. Both are equation number 12. So here we have been considered that k2 square positive plus k2 square is our constant. So if we are going to consider minus k2 square, then the equation will be k del square psi by del y, del square y by del y square plus k2 square y will be equal to 0. Got my point? Here, instead of positive k2 square, if we are going to consider minus k2 square, then k2 square will be moved to the left side, it will be plus. So here I written del square y by del y square plus k2 square y will be equal to 0. And for this differential equation, we can found the solution will be c into e to the I k 2 y plus d into e to the minus I k 2 y. Okay, similarly I written. So the derivation part I have been omitted. So you can consider or you can write in your note. No problem. So by considering equation number 12, this will be the differential equation, and auxiliary equation will be how much? M square plus k2 square will be equal to 0. The two roots will be plus or minus I k2. Similarly, here I am going to suggest that if instead of k2 square, minus k2 square, if you are going to consider k2 square, sorry, minus k2 only, minus k2, then your solution will be e to the I root over of k2y plus d e to the minus I root over of k2y. You can write, no problem. But here I am going to suggest that you just write down this note, okay? Now, similarly, the equation number 14 belongs to Z. Okay, equation number 14, this one. If we are going to consider instead of plus k3 square, if I am going to consider minus k3 square, then it will be how much? Del square z by del z square plus k3 square into z. So the similarly the equation 14 will be plus k3 square into z, and the solution will be z equal to e into e to the I k3z plus f into e to the minus I k3z. Let this is your equation number 20. So here we got 18, 19, 20 separate solution of x, y, z. So the general solution of the equation number 3 will be u x y z equal to this one, a e to the I k1x, b e to the minus I k1x, c e to the I k2y plus d e to the minus I k2y, and this one z equal to e capital E to the I k3z plus f e to the minus I k3z. So this will be the general solution if we are going to consider the negative constant. Okay, so now maybe you are going to be think that if in your exam this question is asked, which case you are going to be considered, any one of the case you can consider. See, you can consider case 1 by considering positive whatever we have been discussed. Considering positive constant, you can consider case 1, or you can consider case 2, and another case also we are going to discuss. I am not going to suggest that you are going to consider case 3 because your mark can be reduced because it will be somewhat reduced. By considering case 3, there is no issue, but it will reduce your note, or for the 8 mark question it will be very short. So I will be suggest that either you are going to consider case 1 and case 2 for your exam point of view. Okay, if you are going to consider case 3, no problem, there is no wrong with that, but on the base of the mark it will be somewhat issue. So I'll suggest that either we are going to consider case 1 and case 2. Okay, case 3 we are going to discuss. Case 3 we are going to discuss. Before that, here you can see we got this one. By considering negative constant, we got this one, the general solution. Okay, whenever you are going to study the quantum dot, or particularly in 3 dimensional box in your 5th semester, 6th semester, here I written important point. This x1, the solution whatever we have, again it has been further solved with sine and cosine. How it is? You can see that this is your a e to the I k1x. this a e to the I k1x and b e to the minus I k1x can be written as a into see e to the power I k1x can be written as cos k1x plus I sin k1x, right? Similarly, e to the minus I k1x can be written as cos k1x minus I sin k1x. So here x will be a into cos k1x plus I sin k1x, b into cos k1x minus I sin k1x. So here a plus b cos k1x plus, here you can see ia minus ib, ia minus ib sin k1x, here also sin k1x common, I taken common, so sin k1x. So a plus b considered as another constant a1 cos k1x plus, here this one considered as another constant, that is your b1 sin k1x. So in your sine cosine format, this exponential solution has been modified or further simplified to the sine and cosine form. So x will be a1 cos k1x plus b1 sin k1x. Similarly, y, whatever we have, c e to the I k2y plus d e to the minus I k2y can be written as y will be equal to c1 cos k2x plus d1 sin k2x. Similarly, z will be written as e1 cos k3x plus f1 sin k3x, and the general solution will be uxyz will be a1 cos k1x, b1 sin k1x into c1 cos k2x plus d1 sin k2x, e1 cos k3x into plus f1 sin k3x, where a1, b1, c1, d1, e1, f1, the constants can be evaluated by using boundary condition. How it can be evaluated, that we are going to discuss in our next class with a new another problem. So here I suggest that for this question, if exam, in your exam it has been asked, first the point is that you can consider case 1 or case 2, and the last solution will be this one. You can write this one or in this format, this one. So here I discussed in this format because it will be useful, this format in cos and sin format will be useful in your fifth and sixth semester and other different problems itself. So 2a you have to be write down in your note, but in your exam either up to this much you have to write, or further simplification if you are going to consider, then this will be the sine and cosine form solution. Okay, now we are going to go for the case 3. By considering each term of the equation number 7 is 0. Equation number 7 is what? Here equation number 7. Here this one. This one is our equation number 7, and this one is your equation number 7 also. Here I taken these two terms to RHS side, right hand side, but this and this are both are equation number 7. Okay, so here this term plus this equal to 0. So I can consider this one will be equal to 0, this one will be equal to 0, this one will be equal to 0, then this equation will be satisfied. Okay, so by considering each term of the equation number 7 is 0, case 3, then that means 1 by x capital X del square x by del x square equal to 0, 1 by y del square y by del y square equal to 0, 1 by z into del square z by del z square equal to 0. So here del square x by del x square will be equal to 0. Now we have to integrate both the side with respect to x, with respect to x. So integration of del square x by del x square into dx, here I written dx, equal to integration of 0 will be 0. So this will be, here double derivative is there, so integration means one derivative will be removed, it will be del x by del x plus a equal to 0, integration constant I have been, this a is considered as integration constant, so del x by del x equal to minus a. Now we have to again integrate both the side, so with respect to x, with respect to x, so del x by del x, we can get with respect to x, integrating with respect to x, we can get del x by del x into dx minus a into dx integration. So here again another derivative will be removed because here integration is there. So it will be x plus integration constant, suppose b1, okay. So here minus ax plus, here this side integration constant is suppose a1. So x will be equal to minus ax plus a1 minus b1. Let a1 minus b1 is your b. So x equal to minus ax plus b is a solution. Okay. Likewise, you can do by yourself. 1 by y del square y by del y square will be equal to 0. Similarly, in the same procedure you have to follow, and you are going to get y equal to minus c y plus d. And for this differential equation, if you are going to follow the same procedure, same steps, you are going to get z equal to minus e y plus f. So the general solution will be minus ax plus b into minus cy plus d into minus ey plus f. So here we have been discussed to solve the Laplace equation which is in the Cartesian coordinate system by considering positive constant and negative constant and by this method. So you have to write down all the three cases in your note, but however, in your exam point of view, for your exam point of view, I suggest that either you can consider the positive constant or negative constant. Either you have to consider positive constant or negative constant as your wish. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. Watch carefully, write down the note, and ready for the next class. In our next class, we are going to discuss solve Laplace equation in two dimension, that is your del square y by del x square plus del square u by del y square equal to 0 in a rectangular plane given boundary conditions are this one. Here boundary conditions are given means we can found the constants. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.